Recently, my wife Joy and I set up a micro school in southeast Atlanta called the Forest School. It's in a neighborhood called Pinewood Forest. And the mission of our school is that each person who enters our doors will find a calling that will change the world. And so our vision very much centers around purpose. We understand from the research that, and actually the Graduate Aims database is what taught us this. So there's a Graduate Aims entry on purpose. And so what we did as a team is we read that entry. It's about 10 pages long, very user-friendly, practitioner-facing. It's a synthesis of all the best research from learning science and from youth development that we understand about purpose. And so we learned some key things as we read that. For example, we learned that most folks don't find their purpose in life until like late 20s. And so despite the fact that our mission of the school, which is for ages 6 through 18, very much before the late 20s, is about purpose, we realized what we needed to be doing as a school is not helping young people find their one and done fixed purpose in life, but rather help them build purpose-seeking skills. And so that became a real focus of our school. As we continue to read the Graduate Aims database, basically what we did is we crosswalked the Graduate Aims entry on purpose with the actual design and experience of our school model. And as we crosswalked that research with our school design model, a number of things happened. One, we affirmed some of what we had designed and thought, that's great. The research affirms this. Let's etch it in stone. Let's leave it. Let's do it. We also realized some greater nuance from the research, and we made a few tweaks and changes. We added some things. We also subtracted a few things. I remember one of the key takeaways from the Graduate Aims entry on purpose had to do with the role of artistic self-expression in finding your purpose. And when we looked at that and found that insight, we looked at our school model and thought, oh, we actually have not given our young people enough time to have that kind of self-expression on a regular basis. And if we're going to cultivate purpose at our school, we need to embed artistic self-expression pretty regularly throughout. And so we actually changed our budget, and we hired more of an art teacher, and now we're sort of implementing that. So we added some things, we subtracted some things, and then we also became aware of some tensions that we just needed to kind of keep an eye on, because when we looked at the research, we noticed, as just an example, that when it comes to purpose, just because someone finds their purpose in life, that's not necessarily translating into academic achievement. But they're both important for us as a school, and so for us, that's a tension that we want to be aware of. We don't want to, have the pendulum swing too far one way or the other. So that's just an example. So, and there are other graduate database grad aims entries, such as self-awareness, empathy, that we also crosswalked against our model. But that practice was very helpful for us in founding the school. And one of the other things we did after we crosswalked it was, in order to double check our understanding and make sure that we were accurate in our application and of the research, we reached out to a few educational researchers and youth development researchers and asked them, like, here's how we're making sense of this graduate database entry in our own learning environment. Can you give us feedback on how we're making sense of it? Is that accurate or not? And they gave us great feedback, and affirmed most of the changes that we made, and helped us tweak a few.